Good morning, owls. Are we ready to figure out the day of the week? All right, let's sing our song. Days of the week. 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 There's Sunday and there's Monday. There's Tuesday and there's Wednesday. There's Thursday and there's Friday. And then there's Saturday. Days of the week. Days of the week. Days of the week, days of the week, days of the week. Okay, friends. Yesterday was Monday. Oh my goodness, look at that. Yesterday began with our letter of the week, the letter M. So cool. So that means today is Tuesday. So tomorrow will be Wednesday. Good job. Yesterday was Monday. Today is Tuesday. Tomorrow will be Wednesday. Good job, owls. So, today is Tuesday, April the... Let's take a look at the number we have here. I have a 2 and an 8, the 28th. So, let's say this all together. Today is Tuesday, April the 28th. Good job, owls. Pat yourselves on the back. Kiss your brain. Say good job, brain. All right. Now, as I said before, our letter of the week is the letter M. So let's see. I have uppercase M and lowercase M. So uppercase M is the mountain. Okay. Lowercase m looks like a hill. But remember, mountain. So uppercase M is a mountain. And look, I have a monkey with a mop right there. Both of those words begin with the letter M. What else begins with the letter M? Oh, you know what? Lincoln found some marshmallows yesterday. Marshmallow. That begins with the letter M. Oh my goodness. Let's see, what else begins with the letter M? How about mitten? We wear mittens on our hands to help keep them nice and warm. What else can you think of that begins with the letter M? Oh, I know you guys are going to do a good job with that. Now, this week, we're talking about our letter M, but we're also talking about the pond. Now, a pond is an area of still fresh water. That means the water doesn't have any salt in it like the ocean does. Because remember, the ocean is really salty water. This is fresh water. This is water we could drink. But we don't drink water from the pond. We drink water that we get from the refrigerator or from the faucet. Okay, guys? So, it's an area of still fresh water. And it doesn't have moving water like a river. It's much smaller than a lake. And ponds are made from rainwater or from spring water that's below the ground. It comes up and it fills the area with water. And you know what? A pond could also be man-made. Now, I want you to take a look at my pond. My pond has an animal in it right here. This is a... a frog. Now, I'm going to teach you a really cool new word. It's a big word, okay? This word is amphibian. Can you say that with me? Amphibian. That's a really big word, isn't it? And a frog, little frog right here. Our frog is an amphibian. An amphibian means that the animal spends the first part of life in water and the second part on land. So our frog hatches from an egg that's in the water. Okay. And then when it hatches, it has gills, and it has fins, and it can breathe under the water. Can you breathe under the water? No, because we don't have gills. We have lungs, and we need air to breathe. We don't need water to breathe. Later, their bodies change, okay? And they grow lungs, and they grow legs, and they move on to the land, and they use their lungs to breathe. So the first part is in the water, and the second part is on land, and that is an amphibian. So let's take a look at my pond. What do I have in my pond? We're going to look at some pond words. I have a duck. And see, I wrote duck right up there. I have a turtle. I have a frog. I have this plant right here. These are called cattails because they look a little bit like the tail of a cat, don't they? And then I also have lily pads right here. And sometimes the frog or the turtle, they'll sit on the lily pad and they'll get some sun. So these are some things that I put in my pond. I want you to try to draw a picture of your very own pond. And I want you to put some vocabulary words that I sent you for pond words. Now, my pond words, I chose a few. I chose duck. I chose lily pad. I chose turtle. I chose frog. And I chose cattail. And I also wrote pond underneath here. So you can draw. You can write. You can tell mom and dad about the description of your pond. But I know they are going to be awesome. So this week, we're talking about pond. We're talking about our letter M. And I want you to remember, M says M, M, M. And our vocabulary word for this week is amphibian. An amphibian means that the first part is spent in water, and the second part is spent on land. All right, I can't wait to see your ponds, owls. I'll talk to you later. Bye.